Can you see what that's
and
doing?
I don't want to miss it.
It's your battery's dying.
Oh, come on. You give me some.
What did Ottawa University have to do to win the Vanier Cup? We were in the Western Division of the Ontario Quebec Football League. Queens, Toronto, Carleton, Bishops, Concordia, and McGill were in our division. We had to win our league, and then we defeated Toronto for the Yates Cup, Windsor, the Churchill Bowl, and the Calgary Dinosaurs for the National Championship Vanier Cup, giving us a total of 11 wins for an undefeated season. We had a dedicated coaching staff, three of whom are here today. Ace Powell, our offensive line coach, and Randy Steele. I've got to ask you to hold your applause because we've got a lot going on here. Danny Slee, defensive backs, both are graduates and Football Hall of Fame inductees of Ottawa University. Bobby Swan was our receivers coach. Dwight Fowler, our defensive
coordinator. Your mom should be up there too.
Jerry
Look
Kwab
at the
defensive line.
The lady
and
went.
Our athletic director was Bob Odovich, who this year will be inducted into the CFL Hall of Fame. Growing up in Ottawa and achieving Hall of Fame status at the university and for the city of Ottawa has a special significance. The city of Ottawa gave us a strong foundation for our team, and I want to recognize these talented student athletes. Jeff Avery, Woodruff High School, a seven-year CFL career and 1976 Grey Cup champion, all with the Ottawa Rough Riders, Woodruff High School.
Hey, Jeff.
Steve Carlo, St. Pat's.
Hey,
Mike Dalton, St. Joe's.
Woo!
Doug Grant, Hillcrest. Doug Grinnell, South Carlton. Julian Hanlon, Colonel By. Kevin Heaney, Hillcrest. Dan Hunt, Colonel By. Connie Mino, Reno High School. Mike Murphy, Hillcrest, a six-year CFL career, and Frank M. Gibson Trophy for Outstanding Rookie in the Eastern Division. Billy McNeely, Gloucester. Eric Upton, Confederation High School. Eric had a 10-year CFL career and five-time Grey Cup champion. Greg Mazur, Maryvale. Chuck Weeks, our trainer, Laurentian. And these are members of our team who are no longer with us. Michael Craner, Colonel By. Cam Thompson, Bell High School. Clarence Coleman, Real High School. Jerry Burlone, our head trainer. And Bill Sherman, Niagara on the Lake. And the culture and heritage of Ottawa and the University of Ottawa helped attract so many other accomplished players. Ottawa University, Canada's university, the largest bilingual university in the world, gave our players the opportunity for a quality education. After hearing Neil Lumsden was the best big back in Toronto from four different high school coaches, I contacted Neil and met with him in Toronto. I told him to think about being the best big back ever to come out of Canadian intercollegiate football. The rest is history. Neil, who had a 10-year CFL career, was a Grey Cup Canadian MVP, three-time Grey Cup champion, and was inducted into the CFL Hall of Fame as an Ottawa GeeGees. We got the city involved in recruiting. I remember meeting with Al Moffat and his dad down in Ottawa City Hall with Mayor Pierre Benoit, an Ottawa grad and football player alum. The mayor offered Mr. Moffat a cigar. He took it, fired up, held up the cigar, and remarked, "I think Al is going to like Ottawa." Al, who came up big, real big, in the Vanier Cup game, had a six-year CFL career, and Wayne Gretzky was inducted with Al into the Brantford, Ontario Hall of Fame. The riders were practicing that day, and I told them about the opportunity, the quality education, and quality football program. Rocky, who had a 14-year CFL career, is a Grey Cup champion and a member of the Canadian Football Hall of Fame. Years ago, I went to a game at Irwin Stadium in Hamilton. I looked over at the Wall of Fame and saw Rocky DiPietro's name, and I cried. Miles Burrell came to Ottawa University off the oil rigs in Calgary. Miles wanted to be part of it. Miles had a 19-year CFL career as a Grey Cup champion and a Canadian Football Hall of Fame inductee. Where's Miles? What is the legacy of the 75 GeeGees collegiately, professionally? Aside from becoming the first undefeated team in Vanier Cup history, today, some 40 years later, the 75 team still holds several Canadian inter-university and CIS and OUAA team and individual records. Players from the 75 team were selected CIS All-Canadian team 13 times through their college careers. During their CIS careers, players from the 1975 GeeGees were selected as OUAA All-Stars 42 times. In all, 22 players from the 1975 Vanier Cup Championship team would go on to be selected in the Canadian Football Draft, a CIS record. As the 1975 GeeGees moved through their professional careers in the Canadian Football League, awards presented to them include 3 Canadian Football Hall of Fame inductees, 1 Grey Cup MVP Canadian, 2 CFL Frank M. Gibson trophies for outstanding rookie Eastern Division, 2 CFL Leo Dandurand trophy outstanding lineman Eastern Division, 2 CFL outstanding Canadian awards, 20 CFL and divisional all-star selections, 23 Grey Cup appearances, 12 Grey Cup rings, which Eric Upton owns 5 Confederation Vice Versa. These other 75 GeeGees also had CFL experience. Tim Berryman, 7 years. Doug Faulkner, 4 years. Also a member of your very own 1976 Grey Cup champion Ottawa Rough Riders. In fact, Doug and Jeff Avery both won the Vanier Cup in 75 and the Grey Cup in 76. Billy Harrison, 5 years, Ian McPherson, 3 years, and Terry West, 2 years. And I'd like to introduce the rest of the 75 GeeGees who have joined us tonight. Duncan Armstrong, Trenton, Ontario. Kenny Garisco, Buffalo, New York. Mike Kelly, Sault Ste. Marie. All-Canadian Paul Kilger from Cornwall. Mark Ribbons from Burlington, and Danny Sartor from Hamilton. For more information on the 75 GeeGees, go to www.75ggees.com. Our GeeGees were fortunate to have someone tell our story to all of Canada, Bob Elliott. At that time, Bob was a young beat sports writer working for the Ottawa Citizen who began to cover our team in 1974. Bob Elliott, the great Toronto Sun sports writer for nearly 30 years and Cooperstown Hall of Fame member and soon to be Canadian Baseball Hall of Famer, wrote, "Often people ask me, what was the most exciting team that I ever covered? Was it the 1992 Toronto Blue Jays or the 1993 Blue Jays? Neither. My answer is the 1975 Ottawa GeeGees." Of the 250 members of the City of Ottawa Hall of Fame, the 1975 GeeGees become the first football team inducted. The 1975 GeeGees will forever be enshrined in the City of Ottawa Sports Hall of Fame. On behalf of our team, I'm proud to accept this honor. Thank you to the Ottawa Sports Hall of Fame Committee for recognizing the undefeated national champion 1975 Ottawa GeeGees.